Hello everyone, Suzugami here, and today we're gonna review A7D. It's a 9.3 attacker that belongs to the US Tech 3. Now this plane was advertised with its heavy loadout. After I played couple of rounds, both in aerialistic and ground, I realized that the bump loadout is not the best one. Apparently this plane doing much better against other planes. So instead of going for the bases and ground targets, I can actually recommend you to go against other planes. The first advantage we have, since it's an attacker, it spawns in air and you can equip this beautiful AIM-9J Sidewinder air-to-air missiles. So if enemy is 2.5 kilometer away, you can fire your missile. The range is incredible. So what we're doing at the beginning, usually we're playing against French, and French have Vautour plane, that bomber. I don't know how to pronounce it.
Vautour.
Officially, Vautours will start to suffer from Corsairs. Because usual playstyle of Vautours, they spawn in at air as well, at the bomber spawn, and they diving straight into the base, dropping the bombs, and they always go in straight line. Now, since we can also spawn at the air, we can easily catch them, get behind them, and launch our powerful long-range anti-air missile. 2 free kills at the beginning of the match. And rest of the match will be against fighters. It will be much harder. But we're guaranteeing this 2 kills at the beginning. And if you're getting down tiered, you can even get behind enemy fighters that just took off from the airfield. And again, same tactic, launch that long-range missiles. 2 free kills. So I played some matches, and usually my kill count between 2 and 3. It's not impressive as Harrier GR1's kill count, but still, for attacker, it's doing a pretty well job. We are basically an attacker, but our playstyle is more like a fighter with this loadout. And what loadout I'm talking about? Of course, 2 30mm cannon and 2 AIM-9G air-to-air missiles. So our main armament is 20mm minigun with 1000 rounds. Our additional armament is 30mm minigun, and each of them has 353 rounds. Usually first 2 targets I kill is Vautours and of course new British naval aircraft, which is also spawned in midair, Buccaneer. In ground realistic, most of the time I was getting shredded by Gepards. And so it's not the best CAS. Still, A4E is much more superior in ground support. But this might change when devs will add Maverick rockets to A7D, which is laser guided, and that means it can be mouse guided in this game, just like Yak-38's ATGM. It's also 100 meters per second faster than the bullpup. So there's this real life picture of A7D. It wears 4 Mavericks and it looks quite deadly. So here's the loadouts of the A7D. The heaviest one is the first loadout, which adds 5,935 kilogram of mass. The heaviest single bump it can carry is the 2,000 pound one. This loadout adds 5,515 kilograms. Our rate of climb is 55 meters per second. So when you add this loadout, it actually tells how much it reduces from your climb rate. And basically, if you wear this, you can't climb at all. That's why wearing this bump loadouts are quite risky, both for ground and aerialistic. However, there is one loadout that is recommended for both game modes, which is 2 30mm cannons and 2 AIM-9J missiles. It only adds 461 kilogram to your plane. The penetration of the ground belt of the 30mm is 102 and 20mm is 53. That means you can destroy most of the ground targets in both air and ground realistic match. So hey guys, that was honest review about A7D. Get it without fear. It performs much better in air realistic. And in ground realistic, if you want to experience A10 Thunderbolt before it's released, I think this plane is for you. Miniguns are powerful. Enjoy the rest of the clip. Gonna see you next time. Peace out.